Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to discuss about synapse, its types and how it actually transmits the impulses. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Synapse. The junction between the two neurons is called synapse. This synapse is not an anatomical continuation, but it is more of a physiological continuity. The synapse is classified by two methods: anatomical classification and functional classification. Let's study the anatomical classification. Usually, axon of one neuron ends with the cell body, dendrite or axon of the next neuron. Here you can see the axon of one body is in contact with the body of another cell or neuron. Hence, it is called exosomatic synapse. Next one. Here the axon of the neuron is in contact with the dendrite of another neuron, hence exodendritic synapse. Third one. Here the axon of one neuron is in contact with the axon of another neuron, hence exoaxonic synapse. This is the functional classification of synapses. On the basis of transmission, of impulses, the synapse is classified into two categories: electrical synapse and chemical synapse. However, generally when they use the word synapse, it is mainly the chemical synapse. Before explaining, let me explain what is a presynaptic neuron and a postsynaptic neuron. The neuron which transmits the impulse is called the presynaptic neuron. And the neuron which receives the signal is called the postsynaptic neuron. Let's study in detail about the electrical synapse. Now, the physiological continuity between the presynaptic neuron and the postsynaptic neuron of electrical synapse is provided by these junctions called the gap junctions. So there is direct exchange of ions between the two neurons. Now as you can see here in the chemical synapse, there is no direct continuity as in electrical synapse. Because of this, the action potential of presynaptic causes changes in the postsynaptic neuron as well. And as you can see, due to the presence of gap junction, usually there is no delay of the signals between these gap junctions. And one more thing is, the transmission can take place either way. But whereas in chemical synapse, it is only one-way transmission. The electrical synapse is found in neurons, that is the nervous system. It is found in heart, the cardiac muscles. It is also seen in smooth muscles of intestine and lens of the, that is epithelial cells of the lens of the eyes. Now we come to our chemical synapse. As you can see here, the space between the presynaptic and the postsynaptic neuron, there is a cleft or a space called as synaptic cleft. The action potential reaching the presynaptic terminal causes release of neurotransmitters that are substance. Now here you can see the vesicles. These contain the neurotransmitters, and whenever there is action potential change here, they release the neurotransmitter, and those come and attach to the protein, receptor protein here, and hence the action potential changes takes place in the next neuron. We will study it in detail. This is the structure of chemical synapse. As you can see, there is a presynaptic neuron with its membrane, that is the presynaptic membrane, and here it is the postsynaptic membrane of the postsynaptic neuron. Here you can see the vesicles and mitochondria. Before that, I want to tell you something very interesting. Now the presynaptic neuron usually ends up with two branches, one which end in the knob-like structures, hence called the terminal knobs, and another which end in wavy or coil-free endings. Now the one with the terminal knobs, they are more responsible for the excitatory function of the nerve and the wavy or coil free ending are responsible for the inhibitory function of the nerve synapse. Let's come to our synapse. Now, as you can see, our presynaptic neuron here has this orange thing called the vesicles and the mitochondria. Now, mitochondria are very important, as these are synthesize the neurotransmitters, and vesicles, these store the neurotransmitters. And as you can see in the postsynaptic neuron, you can see there are proteins which are called the receptor protein. So the synapses are of two types: excitatory synapses and inhibitory synapses. Now, when the potential action potential reaches the presynaptic axon terminal, the voltage gated calcium channels open. Now, the calcium enters the axon terminal from the extracellular fluid. Now, the calcium ions, these release the neurotransmitters from the vesicles, and these neurotransmitters, they transport from the membrane through the cleft and attach to our receptor, forming the neurotransmitter receptor complex. Now, when this happens, these complexes, what they do is they open the sodium gated channels, and that causes influx of the sodium. Now, as sodium is positively charged, it causes the changes in the action potential of the postsynaptic neuron. That is excitatory postsynaptic potential. Inhibitory function is divided into postsynaptic inhibition, presynaptic inhibition, and rhenchyl cell inhibition. Postsynaptic inhibition, it is also called the direct inhibition. It occurs due to release of an inhibitor neurotransmitter from presynaptic terminal instead of excitatory neurotransmitter. So basically, the release of neurotransmitter here is inhibitory neurotransmitter. Now, the most common is GABA, which means gamma aminobutyric acid. There are others as well. Now, what happens here is the neurotransmitters released are inhibitory. When they reach the receptor protein and form the complex, neurotransmitter receptor complex, instead of opening the sodium channels, they open the potassium channels, and the potassium from the cell enters into the extracellular fluid, and along with, they also open the chloride channels, which influx, that is from extracellular fluid inside the cell, and due to the negativity inside, it leads to hyperpolarization. Hence, it is called inhibitory postsynaptic potential. Next, we move on to the presynaptic inhibition. This is also called as indirect inhibition. Now, here it occurs because of failure of presynaptic axon terminal to release the excitatory neurotransmitter substance. Here, nothing but there is failure of transmission. Then we come on to the Renshaw cell inhibition. Here, in the spinal cord, the anterior nerve root consists of nerve fibers. Basically, the alpha motor neurons, these have two called collateral fibers, and they end one in the normal and one in the Renshaw cells. These Renshaw cells are small motor neurons situated between the large alpha motor neurons. When motor neurons send motor impulses, some of the impulses, they reach the collateral and they reach the Renshaw cell. Now, the Renshaw cell is stimulated, and it causes, in turn, it sends the inhibitory impulses to the alpha motor neuron and causes inhibition. If you have any queries, you can ask in the comment section. And if you have any suggestion or feedback for the way of my explanation, you're most welcome to give your feedbacks in the comment section. Thank you and have a great day.